It's episode 30, you know?
Yeah, episode 30. Oh my god, it sucks so much. I can't believe fucking 30 is so old. Ew,
you're not
gross.
30.
Let's get out
this
of here.
This podcast has 30 episodes. It's episode 30 on the React Lord podcast, and we're back, baby. Okay, see, that was energy.
Yeah,
gave some energy.
That was definitely
some
energy.
Some 28-year-old energy.
Mm-hmm. Like, oh, I'm too cool to hang out with these old fuckers.
30.
Get out of here. Oh my
boomers.
God. This is for 20s and down, okay? But wait, maybe we cap it at like a certain age. You're still old, but like.
No, I'm definitely
young.
Old. Here's the thing, though. So I'm a 1994 baby, which means that, like. You know, it's the cusp. You're right there. You're a bit elder, you know, mm-hmm, a little bit of mm-hmm. a, you know, still
yeah.
a not
93.
An, yeah, but we're not elder millennials. Like, we can't, I don't know. We don't have the same experiences.
No.
They're
we're like
40.
The youngest of, you know I think we're the last gen of millennials,
I think they're 45.
Right?
Yeah, I think like the oldest millennial is like 40 something.
Mm-hmm. Technically, it would be like my brother. I think 1996 was the cutoff.
Oh, so he's just like the youngest millennial.
He is like
the
last millennial.
Yeah. So like, I don't know. We're not the last millennials, but we're not boomers. I can't vibe with a boomer.
No.
I just like.
I think if you're 5'3", you're it, like.
You're forced to be younger for a little bit longer,
yes,
right?
You're like terminally young.
So, you know, not only. Are we not actually boomers, but we're short, so we get to like, you know, extend our
youth valor every day.
It's the best kind of valor to steal, dude. It's the best kind of valor to steal. Anyway,
so.
Episode 30, dude, let's start the way I guess we always do, is just what's going on in the world of Nathan. It's been all week since we've hung out.
This is true.
Because we usually just hang out on Sundays now because we're old.
I didn't come over at all during the week. I feel like the week is kind of a blur, so I can't really remember.
Did you? No, I don't think so, because I've been watching a lot of TV and playing Hogwarts Legacy, and I remember sending you like clips of both.
Okay.
So I feel like if you were here, we would have just done that together.
Probably.
Yeah. So I miss you.
I miss you too, dude.
Yeah. You gotta come over, dude.
I will.
I just text you the things that I'm watching now.
Yes.
I'm just like, did you
I
see
appreciate
this
those texts, though.
Stuff?
I like, do.
Yeah. I pet a cow in Hogwarts Legacy recently. That was a pretty big thing for this week. No, I submitted my portfolio this week.
Good freaking job.
Yeah, I didn't see you at all.
Yeah.
Because that was due Wednesday. So like from Monday to Wednesday, I was just hibernating, and then I like pretty much slept after.
Okay, gotcha.
That was it.
New in my life?
Yeah, what's going on?
Got my ears pierced.
Show them off.
Yeah, went down to
a
sabbatic.
I feel like every other week you have to go up to the camera, show off your newest modification.
Here we are. I got some silver put in my ear. Feels good. Actually, they're like healing very nice. No swelling, no redness. It's not even that tender that like I could still sleep on my side. Of course,
wait,
you
so
know,
is it silver
I feel
or is
it
titanium or what? What is it? Oh, I spilled
no,
shit on me.
It's actually like, if I read the receipt right, it's silver. Like
if you read the receipt,
an
right.
amount of silver with stainless steel or something. So, I mean, I was pretty happy with it.
Nice.
They're definitely nicer than the ones that I got in my first piercing, like the basic stainless steel ball bearings.
Did you keep it local or where'd you go?
Oh, yeah,
so
I went
in
to
LA?
Somatic in, here in Long Beach. It's on Broadway and like Redondo-ish.
Nice.
Best experience ever. Everyone in there was super, super nice, super like attentive. They were very attentive, you know. I was in and out. I like really kind of wish tattoos were the same. I was like, they just like, I don't know. It felt like 2 minutes. They pierced my ear. They put the earring in and then they said, you're all done. I waited maybe a max 10 minutes. I
That's
went
dope,
in,
dude.
Waited 10 minutes, got pierced within 2 minutes. And then they said, bye.
Yeah. I don't think they're, I think somatic. I don't know. Actually, I don't want to talk out of my ass. Cause I've known a few people that work. Is there there's a piercer right on Pine. Do they do walk-ins?
You, like Envy, right?
Ooh, is Envy still there?
I don't think so.
I don't think they are.
Somatic did do walk-ins. I never made an appointment or anything. I just showed up
just
when they
That's
opened.
Sick, dude. Do they, they do tattoos at that Somatic, though?
They do. It's upstairs. Sick. It's so, and the stairs going up to the tattoo parlor is fucking cool.
Nice,
it is
dude.
So cool.
I haven't... I want a tattoo so bad. The last one I got was local. I think it was at... Outer Limits.
Okay.
So right down the street.
Yeah. I love Outer Limits.
Outer Limits is tight. Definitely not a walk-in situation. Though you have to like book months in advance and do several cycles of iterations and
Speaking
stuff.
Of tattoos, though, I am getting,
you're getting
one.
A tattoo?
Already confirmed. Put the deposit down and everything.
Dude, big baller. I'm excited for you, Mister. I'm not doing anything and have nothing to do and fucking no passions about shit. Okay.
You're right. I'm making shit happen. I am making shit happen. It's awesome.
I was going back and editing. I was trying to edit slowly. It's fucking. I'm telling you. I'm okay. Other personal news that affects you is at my work. I'm moving and segueing away from doing a lot of editing and producing work to writing a lot of copy. And I hope that will give me more time to do creative editing.
Okay.
So I started actually editing one of our tier list videos that we did right here on the pod. But going through it was during the red flags. You kept saying so many mean things about yourself. And I'm like, I will not tolerate this. Like, wait a second. You know what I mean? And I don't know. So stop being so hard to yourself.
You might have to revisit because I can't remember what I said.
Oh, no. Yeah. I had
just
clip
off the cuff.
Up. Yeah. You were just being hard on yourself. So,
okay.
Yeah. Look at you. I'm glad that.
Well, we're still single. So.
That's not. You, so I don't think
we're
that's. I don't think that should be a measurement.
I know. I'm just saying shit. I don't know.
Yeah.
Don't
would know. Would you want to date yourself? So isn't that a barometer or something, right? Like, do you love yourself?
Oh my God. I would be so fun. We would have so much fun. That would be
You know
cool.
What we should do is work on an elevator pitch for you. You know what I mean? I've been watching this one TikTok where they go around. It's called Snooze or Schmooze. Uh-huh. And it's like, hey, if I find you a date right now, I'll pay for it. Are you down to go walk around Washington Square Park, whatever, in New York, you know? Mm-hmm. So they go around and they like ask like, hey, I'll pay for this date. Will you want to go out with this guy? Do you think he's cute? And so it just happens. We got to develop a little elevator pitch and just go out and be like, hey, this is my friend Nathan. You know what I mean? Like, would you go on a date if it was all inclusive right now?
Makes me instantly uncomfortable. I don't know, like, I need to unpack that. Why is that making me uncomfortable?
Because I think you're a guy, and I think that's a good place for you to be coming from.
Okay.
Because first of all, maybe there's some part of you that's like, I don't want to go harass girls, and I think it's about approach, right? Mm-hmm. But I think if I'm there with you as like a wingman, and it's not creepy, I think we could, you know, do this for you, get you hooked up. Yeah. I'm the one that's paying for it. You know what I mean? Out of my pocket.
Hey, would you like to go on a date? This person's gonna be paying for the entire thing.
Yeah, or we could even be like less abrasive and not have you there, but there's a picture on my phone.
Okay.
So I go around. True. And like, hey, which, you know, do you like this guy? Do you think he's a cutie? And then I, you know, give the elevator pitch, and I say, I'll pay for your date. Would you do it right now?
Dude, that could be like an early 2000s MTV reality TV show.
You know?
Like, I'm inside the van watching everything like playing out.
Yeah. You know, you get the cue, I tug on my
comments.
Ear, and then you like run. And you're like, hey, I'm
Nathan.
Yeah,
I was here the entire time. I heard what you said.
So yeah, next week. No. But maybe, dude, I don't know. I don't know. I think you being single is all right.
Yeah, I think so too. Yeah. I mean, like, I'm even just open to having fun. I'm just trying to have fun. I'm in like the peak of my life, dude.
Get you a friend date, you know? Get you a friend date.
Yeah.
Totally.
I invited you out yesterday and then you bailed.
You invited me and my wife out after you were already going to go out with my wife and I was doing homework.
True.
So I was like,
I
don't know. But if you ever want to go on a friend date, just me and you, no third wheel.
Uh-huh.
You know.
All right.
Hit me up.
I'm gonna keep that in mind.
On me.
All right, don't
reneg.
Oh, let's go.
All inclusive date.
Let's go.
All inclusive date. I also have another thing to ask you though. So it's not a date, but it is a big favor, and you've kind of already said yes. I asked you to let me use you in a video for school, and you said you were gonna do it.
I'm making Kung Pao chicken, or what was it again?
Kung Pao, right? Okay, so I made a storyboard for you.
Okay. Let's see it.
And I photoshopped.
Are we gonna see it on stream?
I photoshopped you into some images.
Or fuck, not stream, podcast. Are we gonna see? Are we gonna see this on the podcast?
Yes, right now. If I can.
I still
want to
say stream so bad.
We can stream it too, dude. That's your call.
I keep thinking the podcast is the stream.
Hey, it's one button difference.
It is.
Okay,
we
could hit the start streaming button next time.
Okay. Episode 31. You heard it here first.
All right, guys, this is my pitch to Nathan.
All right, let's
okay.
go.
So it's kind of hard to tell, so maybe I'll just have the pictures, and then I will give you the pitch for each picture. How about that? So it starts out with you, Nathan. Mm-hmm. Can you see that?
Yes. I will immediately address the audience.
Yes, you're gonna.
Hello.
You don't have to. Okay, you don't have to read that. This is just from high school. It's really fast. It's not even. No, don't worry about that. You were in a kitchen. I present you the Kung Pao chicken from Panda Express.
Uh-huh.
It is you versus the chicken. You will try the chicken. You will tell us your thoughts on the chicken. And spoiler alert: we will have the ingredients for you to actually try to recreate this chicken or make it better. Hopefully, you don't regress and make a worse chicken. Are you in?
I'm in.
That's the challenge.
Okay.
Okay. So we're into the challenge. You taste test the chicken. You're going to give us some feedback on, you know, the notes of the chicken. You're going to tell us, this is what I love about it. I'm going to try to recreate this. Maybe add a different ingredient for your own kit. I don't know. Let us know what you're going to do. How are you going to tackle making this Kung Pao chicken?
Mm-hmm.
How you liking this so far?
I feel like if I was a cheater,
yeah,
I would watch a Joshua Weissman video. And see if he's made it better.
He probably has. I chose this because I thought it was a good challenge that you probably haven't done specifically, but it's something that's doable. I didn't want to give you like cook a soup, like a filet, I don't know, a
souffle
or some other insane, like, you know, crazy thing.
Yeah. And my hot take, though, is also souffle is kind of mid.
And also, like, what, okay. If I asked you to like make a medium steak, something that you've already done or something, like that's boring, right?
Yeah. Oh, and I think it would be like too short of a video because a steak's gonna cook fast and we'll plate it super fast.
What it's do you just compare steak. It to? Like a black Angus steak? I don't know. So there was supposed to be like a challenge, a direction, right? So like I was just trying to come up with something that I could emulate, and this will be fun.
I think so.
Let's keep going. So you do your taste test and then you start chefing it up. Mm-hmm. So I imagine B-roll, right? Maybe if you hit a snag or like you burn something or something goes really well, you might say something quippy or funny. I'll add sound effects to make it, you know, extra impactful. But you're in the kitchen for this little part, little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So after you
actually... Where a man should be. I'm just kidding.
Nathan's going to stay in the fucking kitchen where he belongs. You do belong there, though. You're a really good chef.
I mean, I like being in the kitchen. I was saying it joking, but only half.
He does love being in the kitchen. So think B-roll, think action shots, maybe a montage is taking place. We slow the montage, there's a cut to you saying something, right? You know, pans. Boom. Okay, we're out of...
Pans.
Yeah, both
pans.
Yeah. So then, boom, your plate. The Kung Pao chicken from Panda.
Mm-hmm.
They're side by side. It's done. We zoom out. Boom. You're sitting there looking at both.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So we'll judge it on aesthetic, like how it looks visually.
Yeah.
Then we'll judge it on taste, whether or not it's better or not.
Maybe you say something about the process. What was the most challenging? What's the final grade? That's this shot, really. Okay. So it culminates with you going, you know. So finally, I would have given, you know, this Panda Express a B+. Okay.
Sorry.
A+, S tier, whatever you're, you know.
I mean, if we're going off like a prior tier list.
Listen,
you know.
I love Panda, but I'm not going to sit here and lie to you and say that it's consistently great. There could be an off day that you get this Kung Pao chicken, to be honest. Like,
I have to disagree.
I mean, that's fine.
Okay.
We disagree. So at this point, you have a grade for both. Maybe yours is higher. Maybe it's not, just based on how you're talking about Kung Pao chicken.
Fair.
Maybe he can't beat the challenge, and that's okay.
That's possible.
I've never
made it before.
At the end, I'll interview you. And I'm going to ask you just a few questions about, you know, like, I noticed that you fumbled the ball over here, or I noticed you excelled really well in this part. You know, was your favorite part?
We cooked.
Yeah, and we conquered. We failed miserably. Like, I don't know. That'll depend, you know, something along those lines of just like the final takeaway, final thought, like, get out there, try something new kind of vibes.
Okay. Hell yeah.
Yeah. Fade to black.
I think it will be fun.
Yeah.
I'm actually really excited. I think it's one to be in front of the camera. For some reason, I find that much more natural for me to do than trying to do all the behind the camera stuff.
Yeah. I mean, I definitely am excited for the behind the camera stuff.
And that's why I think this is going to go really well.
Yeah. And I think the last part will kind of be like this, but it'll just be like a one mic kind of thing. And I'll just be.
Okay.
You.
Okay.
Like this.
Gotcha.
Something like that. I don't know. We'll figure it out. I definitely wanted to be way more structured than our podcast.
Do you wear wigs? When will you wear wigs?
Venable, you wear wigs. What is that from?
It's some stupid interview, meme interview on the Lord of the Rings or something when Elijah Wood and his co-star. We watched that.
You're right. We did. Sorry, I'm like setting up the next
scene. I was just thinking like interview okay? process.
Oh no, I'm so sorry. Spoiler.
That's okay. Okay. True spoiler.
Oh my God, stop, dude. Anyway, moving on from Panda. Let's talk internet shit because the internet's been popping off and doing funny things.
Let's go. What's the new meta?
The new meta. Let's see. Where do we start? I'm going to start with an old video to explain the new meta.
Mm-hmm. There's actually a loaded question. It's feet pics. I'm just kidding.
I hate you. I hate you so much. Let's just start out with this.
How much would you need to expose feet on the podcast?
For free?
Oh, you do it for free?
No, I'm asking free.
No. Like, How much do you need?
Oh, so you are talking monies.
Or anything.
I thought
you were
talking
like a
subscriber limit. You know what I mean?
I give you a sofa from Urban Outfitters and you give me those feet pics?
So no. I might do it for free if like there was a sub rate.
You heard that first, commenters.
You know what I mean? Like, I'm not protective of my feet. Uh-huh. I certainly don't sexualize them. And if there are people out there that want to... If you know what, 4 million subs.
Charge them. Yes.
4 million subs. I think that's reasonable.
4 million.
Yeah. For free. I'll give it four. You know, all you gotta do is hit the subscribe button. That's
how many
free.
Subs does Mr. Beast have? Do you know?
Like fucking 48 million.
Okay. So 4 million is like easy.
Well, Ludwig has 4. Okay. So like it's not easy, but it's possible. I mean, weirder people have more subscribers for shit.
Okay.
I think of the top 5 guy. I don't know. He's just like a toxic guy and he's got millions of subscribers. And I think feet can be more compelling than that. So.
Fair.
And Hassan Piker knows that. So here is his feet for absolutely free. He doesn't have 4 million subscribers.
We're redistributing the feet.
We are right here on this podcast for free. Mm-hmm. And like I said, this motherfucker doesn't have 4 million subscribers and he's out here giving his feet for free.
True.
So maybe I'll actually lower my bar. I don't know, dude. I don't have a threshold. How about you? You're almost there right now.
True. I got the sockies on though.
That's a sneak peek.
Yeah.
That's a
clothed foot.
Our future employer. Was this you talking about your feet?
No. Yeah.
Maybe. Do you want to see them?
That'll be $50 though.
No, but would you do that? I mean, I was actually reading an article earlier in the week about someone who makes like $200K doing it.
So, really?
Yeah, a month.
I mean, yeah.
That's most than, you know, any top tier streamer.
Yeah, for
know,
$200K, I'd show them every day.
You got good feet, too. And you bicycle.
Yeah, they're not bad. They're not bad. They're the whitest part of my body. Because they never see the sun. Well, I always have shoes on.
This is getting racial.
Oh, sorry. They're the lightest.
It's the whitest, lightest, most expensive part of my body.
Stop. The cops would never arrest me if they only saw my feet.
Anyway, here's your free feet, courtesy of Hassan Piker on his Twitter. So, if that's what you're into,
those feet got him out of a DUI.
Did they really?
Okay. I don't know.
They are pretty white. I don't know. But there is a more alarming trend going off. And I'm going to be the first to say that I'm super guilty. It has nothing to do with feet. But it does have to do with coppers. And it is pretty funny. It's good content. It's obviously a bad thing to do. We don't condone crime.
But it's happening.
It is. And it's televised. It's a live broadcast on an actual news. Anyway, so we got streamers out here just reacting to like police chases. I have actually become a bit of an avid fan of police chases. I think it's exhilarating.
It is, though. I mean, it's like there's a lot going through a person's mind watching a police chase. Like, are they going to get caught? Will they get away?
I mean, as long as nobody is actively getting hurt, I find joy in it. Like, I'm just saying, I know it's a dangerous situation to be in, but it is a televised event. Like, why are you televising it if you're not trying to use it as entertainment? That is silly.
Yeah. The only time that makes me uncomfortable is when guns are involved. And was one
it's
that you sent me, and it was just like, everything was fine. I thought it was like entertaining until shots came out of the fucking car.
But it's America, so there's I think guns. You always have to just assume guns are going to be involved to some degree.
Yeah, but for the most part, the ones we see on like KTLA, like for the most part, they don't have any guns involved
until they end.
Until they end.
Until they end.
But there's not like.
Because cops don't know how to de-escalate
any shots being shot, you know what I mean?
Yeah. So here's just an example. So 3 months ago is kind of when I started seeing the trend take off. And this is the first one I remember. And it wasn't on XQC stream even. It was actually on Hassan Piker's stream. I couldn't find that clip when I was looking it up.
Gotcha.
And this one came up because obviously it's most popular. Mm-hmm. So we're going to watch a clip from this one, which is the first one I remember seeing.
Okay.
Here it is.
Lights and sirens on.
Pretty exciting stuff.
Maybe 50 feet back. Let's go ahead and widen out and see which agency that is.
So you can't really tell. He doesn't have a tire on the back one there.
Still Fullerton. It's Fullerton PD. Fullerton PD.
Should specify, every single one of these is in LA. Like, it's in Los Angeles.
Where the fuck is Fullerton in here then? That's Orange County.
Okay, dude, that because you live in LA, you think that. You know what I'm saying? It's all Southern California.
Oh, got it.
Yeah, okay. They're going to talk about San Diego, but where do they end up? LA, right? Like, they're going to talk about Anaheim, but where do they end up? Somewhere around LA.
What's also wild is, like, I don't even think that the PD have jurisdiction on the freeway. Isn't that Highway Patrol? So why the fuck are they even doing anything?
I think they all like to play together.
Yeah.
Okay. They are all the same picks, I guess.
This guy was actually living
his tire is gone again. This is the
that's so fucking cool though.
Again, as long as he's not hurting on it, this is kind of cool. Like, he's trying to get away.
No. That's not that five head. Everyone has that same idea.
Okay, it does go wrong here. I believe he gets stuck or something.
Traffic.
Ramming into all of these cars here. Sorry. Again, sorry. This is northbound Carmenita Road now.
Oh, yeah. He done.
No.
He's stuck.
No, he's not done. No, he's not done. He's getting started.
On foot? Are we continuing on foot or what?
I'll fast forward in a second. I just wanted you to see this part.
Holy.
Sparks flying, and that patrol, that officer right there, has to treat this with kid glove care.
This guy's tripping donkey balls,
likely
bro,
gonna have to step away.
Yeah, but if he was doing that, he wouldn't have parked literally behind him. What an idiot.
I mean, he's probably trying to get him stuck in there, right? He's trying
to. So why didn't you park in front of the van?
Yeah, this is likely to start a fire. You can see those rims are starting to glow.
Okay, a fire on what? What's gonna burn it?
It's kind of tight.
There's certainly more on the way over here right now.
Okay, the determination in this man.
Just that one black and white. Just the one black and white. We're at Placid Drive, northbound Carmenita Road, and he is now stranded here. We'll see how this officer deals with this. He's likely just going to wait for backup.
Okay, let's just fast forward. He gets away. He ends up taking another car.
Wait, like he takes the car from someone else?
Yeah, like this would be his third carjacking. So he goes on. He does get busted. Finally, another you know, copper gets behind him.
Oh, wait, I have seen this.
This was one of the first big ones that I saw. This was a huge
event. We saw it together.
Except
I didn't see the beginning part. I must have been like working or something.
Yeah, I think we missed it. And then if you tuned in from like the beginning, he started in this car. He jumps into the white van and then finishes in this truck. Like, okay, all over LA. Technically, I guess Fullerton to LA, but like Long Beach was involved too, which isn't like city limits. Mm-hmm. This one is the one. This is the one I sent you, dude.
Yeah, this
is like
was
down
fucking
the
crazy.
Street. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Anytime I see PCH, I know it's a really long highway, but that's home. You know what I mean?
I mean, Poly High District?
Yeah, true.
I know
alert.
Exactly. I pass by that all the time.
Yeah, this one does have.
Are used to
in it. I do want to preface it though, nobody was actually hurt. No shots were hurt anybody throughout the whole thing, and police fire too. Like, everybody was firing in this one.
Well, I mean, they'll take any opportunity to shoot their gun, their murder dildo.
So okay, this man just like found himself in Long Beach and then shoots out his own window. But before this had happened, check this out. Shit's fucking wild.
710? Nope.
91. But he comes to like this random stop.
Has to, does, you
just pushing 100. I think it's right around here.
That he's got a full tank of gas. We have to hope that the tank was almost empty and maybe they didn't have time to fill the gas up yet. We don't know. But in any event, he's now starting.
That's impressive for a truck.
To the right, maybe trying to get
the speeds?
Traffic,
yeah.
Or maybe thinking about an exit plan.
Okay, he's slowing down. Hold on, this might not be the spot. Dude,
I feel like he's just burning through the juice, though.
Yeah, I feel like anytime a Tesla's involved in one of these, it's like, that sucks, because your car's going to have to, like, go away for 4 months to get that shit fixed.
Yeah.
Anyway, right around here, he starts shooting at the police on the freeway, okay? He gets off on the surface streets, in which and he speeds through, I think, Anaheim at this point, Artesia, right? Goes through a school zone. This is probably the scariest part of the whole fucking encounter. And police in nowhere in sight. Like, he's just... It's just kids.
Look at this. A whole bunch of... Look at this. A whole group of kids crossing the street. School...
Yeah, that's fucking...
He has shot at police.
This is the worst. Let's just hope he continues through... At a slow clip here, lets the kids cross and just keeps going. Nobody here.
Not the one straggler, man.
What has happened or what is going on?
So he's taken off. He takes off, right? Eventually,
yeah.
He does get busted.
I mean,
he does get busted in Long Beach. But I mean, like, he tears through Long Beach, dude. Runs into a pole, eventually, like, right off of 7th. Anyway, this is the new meta. Just giving, you know. Crime news updates, baby. It's popping off.
I would love to see, like, the, like, general idea of others. Like, what do you guys think? Is this okay? Do you find this entertaining like we do?
100%. You should see the comment section.
Okay. That's what I'm hoping.
I mean, listen, there's literal nights where I'm like, I wonder if there's going to be a car chase tonight.
I feel like it's, there's usually, I think there are more than there, than, like, we see
in
the media.
So here's the thing. It doesn't make me want to go do a car chase.
No.
Like, I don't want to go do crime. I don't want to be a crimer. I just want to watch the crimers. Do you know what I mean? There's always been a level of, like, I don't know, copaganda in our lives. I mean,
I think the baseline is copaganda.
Yeah. So I think we're all just like, we're into it.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know what I mean? I don't know.
I really couldn't give a shit about the cops.
Yeah. 10 out of 10, though.
Sorry.
This meta, I mean, again, as long as no one is getting hurt on, like, live television or whatever, and it's simply a chase with, you know, fun stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm down for the new meta.
I don't know what else to say about it, actually. I like, am ruminating on this thought of, like,
violence
car chases
for entertainment. Yeah.
And, like, yeah. It's, like, I really do think, like, there's probably a car chase or a car speeding, like, every night.
Yeah.
Probably multiple.
At what point does it transform?
Into, like, a helicopter capturing it on camera.
Yeah, like, if we were going to unpack this,
yeah.
It's not a great meta. Because it is, in a way, you know, it's using the plight of others, right? So a lot of these people, the crimers, they're doing crime for other circumstances. And then we have the cops that are usually, especially in LA, just absolute special
garbage.
Folks.
Yeah.
It's just, you know, they're particular about the way they do things, and it's often not an effective way to do anything. And that's what we see a lot of the times in this. They can't spike strip. They can't pit. They can't stop. They can't swarm. They can't keep up. Like,
yeah,
you know?
I think, though, that there is a caveat in the sense of, like, it's happening. And it's being made available.
Without,
like,
and,
the input
or choice
of anybody. And, I mean,
ABC7 is broadcasting it live for our consumption. It's not like it's a private feed that's going directly for the police and it's only being used for that. No, this is broadcasted for views on their YouTube channel, which is monetized. And so, listen.
I really, like...
There's no ethical consumption under capitalism,
exactly.
Dude.
That's what I was thinking. And I think that's what we were really... implying.
Yeah, let's just say it, dude. This shit's wild. It's fun to watch, but it's honestly, like, just it is what it is.
Yeah.
It's made available to us. And that's exactly what TikTok is. Made available to us. Today I tried to log into my TikTok. I logged out of the React Lore TikTok. because I don't do anything on that TikTok anymore. So I was like, let me log into my personal one because I don't know, there were some things I liked, and I logged in using my email and it prompted me to make a brand new TikTok account, which freaked me the fuck out because I'm like, where's my old TikTok account? I'm like, you know, a lot of videos posted on there and some things in the draft, and I had liked some things and tailored my algorithm.
Think again. Not anymore.
So I don't know. It made me make a new TikTok account. And before I stopped myself, I thought it would just be fun to have it, to see kind of the algo that TikTok might push a new person signing up to TikTok. So if anyone's ever wondered, and you know, what is TikTok about and you don't have one, we could show you what going in raw looks like.
Stop, dude. Flashbacks like to episode 29.
You like that?
I did.
Yeah,
I did.
You did.
I did.
I'm sure you did like going in raw.
I heard it raw. All
right. Let's get it going. I got to get like a little stand for this.
True. Or like some Iron Man setup.
Anyway, let's hit it raw. Okay, let's do it. Here it is, brand new. Again, just made, like, doesn't have a profile picture. All it does is have my name. It does have my age, though, and I'm wondering if that is going to influence what it thinks I might want to see as a boomer. Okay, because Simpsons.
Thought we already established we're stealing youth valor, okay?
It took me 20 years to realize what this scene actually meant.
Wait, what? I missed the scene. I don't like it already.
It took me 20 years to realize what this scene actually meant.
All right, fuck it, let's hit it raw. I don't know what's going on that.
I'm fighting you in the cold, bro. We'll smack the shit out of you, but I can't feel my hands. I throw one punch, it's gonna hurt me, nigga. Let's fight tomorrow. Let me check the weather for tomorrow. Tomorrow gonna be 24. Nah, I don't know, right? 33? Nah.
He seems reasonable so far. I'm gonna like it.
We gonna be under 50. I'm not fighting you under 50, bro. Let's wait till summer, gang. We can wait till summer. Until summer hit, you know I'm gonna hop out of. Matter of fact, you my man, all right?
Bro, we should let you laugh you lose on a random TikTok thing. Let's do that.
Starting now.
But can I get a? I gotta get a count. Hold up. If we're gonna do
can
it,
can I get a?
Hiya. You can get the shut the fuck up. Oh my god, I hate you, brother. Okay, here we go. So we'll put. Oh, this is going to be kind of hard for me to keep up with, but I like it. We'll figure it out. Are you not going to laugh? Because I was already laughing pretty hard.
I don't know how to laugh.
I don't think that's true.
I've never laughed in my life.
You can only laugh once per TikTok, so you can laugh twice during a TikTok and still get away, you know, with multiple laughs and only count as one. We'll start out with one because we've already laughed. Does that sound fair?
Fine. Shit.
You better get that shit out. Let's rename this so we're not thinking like who's who here.
Laugh-o-meter. That's a boomer joke.
I was gonna ask. What
I
the
think
fuck
something
is that,
just
dude?
Happens at 3-0. Your brain chemistry
Don't
changes.
Call 30-30. Don't do that.
I told you.
You can't make it a cool thing.
I told you it breaks my brain.
All right, let's get going. Fuck it. We'll finish this one. You can keep laughing.
Nah, you right.
For sure, man.
I don't even need a grip when I got water. You not my op, bro. I'm not gonna lie. You my mans until summer. Nigga, this whole week below 50. Nigga, you don't got no gloves on, bro?
Nigga, no.
Oh, you don't got no ski mask?
Nah, I can't.
Here, take my shit, bro. In the summer, I'ma fuck you up, nigga. Don't think I ain't hear your new song and shit. You was disrespecting the gods and all that. Just don't worry, bro. Niggas got shit for y'all.
Remember that handshake only valid until the summertime.
When it hits summer, I'ma knock you the fuck out.
I'm just saying, he seems like a reasonable guy.
Until the summertime.
Valid on my block until it get hot. I love you, Mom.
We'll have to revisit him in the summertime because if he is in fact lying, you can laugh during this one because you've already got hammered by it. Okay, are you ready? Composed?
No, I'm not. I'll
give you 5 seconds. 3, 2. We're rolling, bud. Get ready.
So, I was born ready.
Perfectly aligned eyes, but still look like a wad of chewing gum.
Stop.
I want to take my daughter's face.
The plan is to align your eyes using what's called distraction osteogenesis.
Just a minute long.
We cut the bone and implant posts on.
I don't think this is designed to be funny.
Orbits.
I say that.
For mere mortals, it would, but with your pain tolerance.
Is it?
I watched the good
real?
Doctor. No, this is The Good Doctor. Oh, okay. I watched this show.
But like, is that a possible surgery to receive in the real life, IRL?
I don't think so, brother. Maybe.
Oh, what is this for? Well, we're about to get into it. Hold on. Oh. He's going to get slapped with something, and he's going to try and get up.
Oh, you don't care?
And he's not going to be able to get up.
Yeah, I'm
going to
be fine.
Wait, what? Bruh, don't fucking drop me. Stop, stop.
No,
come on.
Just what?
Stop, don't drop me. Don't drop me.
I'm good at this game.
No, no, you're not. Want to
try something?
I didn't get it. And it looked staged because honestly, you saw how she did it.
I know, but it's just, the only reason I laughed is because I thought of my wife. Okay. That's some shit she would do. She would let me on her village farm thing. Some of these are going to be relevant to me. Some of them are going to be relevant to you. Maybe none of them are going to be relevant to either of us, you know?
Fair, fair, fair.
I want an easier way to fucking change those numbers. It's leaning up. You lean up. I'll click.
What do I press?
Buttons.
No, it's a child safety tether. This way, sweetie.
It's a leash.
I had one of those as a kid.
No.
Yeah, apparently I was a runner.
Going through a phase. At least, oh, we hope it's a phase.
She bolts every chance she gets. Lily?
Same.
Lily! So we had no choice but to put her on a child safety tether.
It's a leash. And we did have a choice.
Lily, sweetie, don't pull.
Lily, heel!
Dad.
If I'd have known you guys were going to do this, I'd have brought Stella.
It was Cam's idea.
I'm going through trauma. I'm reliving a trauma right now.
Okay, sweetie, you're not helping. You're not helping. Well, 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 what do you know? Another caring parent with a child safety tether.
Yo, I want to take issue with the fact that these are way too fucking long. I'm going to skip it.
2 minutes, 30 seconds.
Yeah, and I don't think it's funny.
It's just a clip. It's not even like commentary or anything.
This is what TikTok wants us to have as new TikTok users. They don't want us to laugh. Okay, well, so. I've laughed twice, actually.
I am a rock solid. I will never laugh.
4 hours and do anything. What would you do?
I'll go to New York.
I've never been
to New York.
Would you actually want to go to New York tomorrow? All expenses paid?
Let's go.
How are you feeling right now?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's our pleasure to welcome you to New York.
It's cool.
You know what we're doing in New York?
I have no clue. He won't tell me.
Monty, what do you think?
My God!
She has zero clue we have VIP tickets.
We're going to the top.
That's cool.
To the top? Cool. Like, we're going to the top? Well,
Chase Bank? I go there. In a
city. I'm on top of the world! Sweet.
You know where we are?
This is also too long of a TikTok, in my opinion.
It's a minute and 38. We got, what line are we willing to go to?
It's not funny. I'm over it.
Okay, me too.
So,
what was that?
I laughed at my own joke. I didn't laugh at that TikTok. It was not a funny TikTok, if that's what you're...
No. What's that?
Oh, you're talking about this TikTok. Yeah. I was like, come on. Come on. I'm an ego ante. I'm going to laugh at my own shit.
Wax?
Is
candle
it wax?
Or candy? Candle or candy?
Can you not talk? Because it makes me laugh.
Sorry.
And I want to laugh. You're funnier than the TikTok. Fuck.
No, I gotta know what it is.
Bro, it's too long.
Skip to the end. What is it?
You'll just probably never know.
That's gonna bug the shit out of me. Silicone. Why silicone? Why see silicone? What is that? Oh my God. Fucking leave.
11 o'clock.
Yeah. You were so much funnier than the dogs.
Sorry.
Walking by, I'm really hungry.
Nothing is ready. It's almost.
It's not gonna be funny.
Scary.
Full of snow.
Cocaine bear?
Sorry. I didn't mean to do that. And it's a minute long. It's fucking minute long.
You're full of snow.
It's a minute long.
What's it gonna do?
Did you turn around because you want me to scratch you? Do you want this?
Dude, playing with fire. You can't just fucking... No one should have a bear.
Want me to scratch you? Get all the snow off you?
Next.
Get the snow off you?
Yeah, I think this is how I know I'm not
Wait,
a fucking
Wait, is that another
boomer.
Bear?
Yeah,
I think it's a raccoon statue.
Oh.
I'm gonna guess it's a raccoon statue. Some sort of statue.
If you turn around, I'll get the other side.
Not moving. Looks like a raccoon.
Hibernate again. Whoa, okay. Good boy, you did it. Good boy. Sit. Good boy.
Good. You're not getting me. You're not getting me.
I love you, baby.
We poisoned our art teacher. I never really liked my art teacher, but this went too far. My art teacher had put her mug of water beside a friend of mine while she was painting to help another student. My friend thought the art teacher had given her a new water pot to clean her brushes with, so without hesitation, she cleaned her brushes in the teacher's water. 10 seconds later, the teacher grabs the mug and drinks the whole thing. Everyone in the class saw this happen and we were all totally stunned. The next week, my teacher never showed up to art class. I'll be drawing this live tonight on TikTok if you want to hear what happened next.
Brother, did we just get clickbaited by murder?
I think so, but we didn't click on it with intention. It was just the next video.
But we stayed.
Because it was 36 seconds long.
And that's what makes an impactful fucking TikTok, though. I said what I said.
Banana.
Oh, hi.
Banana.
It's a simple banana.
Honey.
No.
Honey.
Yes. You have.
Can I have that?
Yeah.
No.
What are we wanting? I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. What the fuck is this?
They didn't get me. You can't get me.
I was trying to hold it up for so
long. Nah, can't get me. Nah, bruh.
This is avant-garde. This is high-level art. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It's great.
Yeah.
It's great.
Got that milk.
Piece of resistance.
Go, Fee. Go, Fee.
Yeah,
I've missed the banana a little bit.
Okay.
That sounds terrible.
Oh, nice!
Let's try.
Let's try.
Perfect. Let's try.
Oh my god, I'm
that's actually really bad.
Yes.
Banana.
Oh, hi.
Banana.
Okay. He's hot. We're gonna get DMCA probably on. We should probably just move on from this. Dude, I didn't even tell you. Let's pause, actually. We got copyright strike. Like, we had a whole ass video blocked in every country. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I never even told you about it. I fixed it.
Fucking pouring outside.
Oh, it is dumping outside. I gotta take my wife to work then. But okay, anyway,
I got distracted.
We got DMCA'd 3 times the last time we did this like TikTok thing.
Okay.
So, you know, you might not be able to see this part. Let's just keep moving though, because we don't want to have that happen. That was scary, dog. I was like, yo.
Don't fuck with our podcast.
Okay, I'm at my girlfriend's house. Can someone tell me what these categories are?
Part 3. There's a part 3.
Shmungus?
I'm on a VPN.
A VPN into what? Another dimension? I married a shmungus. What the hell is a shmungus? What is the shmungus among us? What the shmungus is revenge? What?
Is that fake?
They stole my shmungus.
What? Okay, I'm at my girlfriend's house. Can someone tell me what these categories
are? Yo, Maxine's a bitch. Birthday.
Thank you.
What are you doing right now? What class do you have?
I have AP English.
want to skip?
Hmm? Haven't you been skipping a lot?
I'm going to go smoke with my mom and
tell her. This video going to give me a seizure?
Yo, Maxine's a bitch.
Wait, I got to see that again. What?
Thank you.
What are you doing right
this
now?
This TV?
I have AP English. Want to skip? Hmm?
Haven't you been skipping a lot?
You think it's like gonna be a thirst trap?
Yo, Maxine's a bitch.
Bitch, who the fuck?
Birthday. Thank you.
Is that a real conversation, though?
You laughed again, son of a bitch.
At what? What was funny?
Hmm? Haven't you been skipping a lot?
I can go smoke with my mom and tell her.
That. That just his, dude. I don't know. Get a fucking sense of humor, bro. Bitch, who the fuck? Exactly.
My mom said she rejected a dozen of guys in her day. I did not believe her. Until.
Hi.
I think the real question is, why is their kid such a fucking asshole? Oh no, what's happening?
I don't know, but I don't want to know. I don't want to know. I don't want to know. I don't even want to watch that TikTok.
Yep, leave.
Okay, we're going to leave. Why did I pass that? I don't know what's going on there.
Big yikes.
My lord. Ma'am. Oh, we got another sugar bush, y'all. Ma'am, you want extra smalls?
We're going to do 5 more, by the way.
Okay.
Yeah.
Micro... No way. No way you put me for no micros to the flow and you pregnant.
I'm assuming you don't understand what's happening here.
Well, I mean, I can gather from context that it's going to be difficult to do what they're asking for some reason relating to the condition of their hair.
Y'all, if you think... Oh, just join my live. I'm live on my backup page until 1 o'clock.
Okay, so I think this is a meta.
Okay.
I think this is a meta. Like kind of baiting you into like watching a longer form thing, and at the end it's like, hey, I'm live.
I do think that this is relatable in the sense of like, I think often normies or people who aren't in a relative like routine of taking care of their body, hair, nails, whatnot, they kind of like ask for the technician or the barber or the hairdresser to like do magic. Like you want them to do something, but you don't understand that it can't be done.
Seems really like a personal anecdote of sorts.
Yeah, I sometimes have expected people to make my dreams come true, but that's not reality, you know? And I'm not alone in that. I refuse to believe I'm alone in that. I've seen it happen.
It's specific, but relatable.
I think so.
I think this is just a bait to get you in a live stream.
Okay.
Let's keep going.
36 short.
Let's start with 34.
Is this a Darmon video?
I think so. And they're at 34? Holy shit. Those don't fit me. Bro. No. I don't fit 34. Is there a little bit too big?
On the jacket or on the pant?
Yeah. I was like assuming they were talking about the blazer.
32?
It's weird. It's like a boob thing. So it's like you want the shoulders to be smaller than a 34, but you need your breast size to be like a 34.
Custom.
Yeah. Yeah. It always is fucking custom. They're not going to find what they need in this damn store.
Refrigerators used to be a lot cooler. And let me show you why.
Let's start with the most ingenious store in any refrigerator.
Was there any way you could pause prices on that first fridge image? Yeah. It's like in color. It's bright out. Right here. Tickling my brain in a way. Look how organized. Oh.
Seems like outfitted. It's not efficient. How does all of it get cold?
Actually, it looks fake.
It does.
Is that even real? Now that I'm looking closer at it, it looks 2D. It looks like an image.
Almost a minute and a half TikTok. Let's get to it.
All right.
Let me show you why. Let's start with the most ingenious door in any refrigerator. It has special places for bottles, spreadable butter, cheeses.
Spoiler alert, we still have that.
Even leftovers, and a big picture window hydrator for fruits and vegetables. It tilts down to show you your supply at a glance. And it also lifts out, so you can take it over to the sink when there's a fresh supply.
That's pretty dope.
Don't show my wife this.
But that's just the door. Think of all you can store in here on these big firm shelves that roll all the way up to you, so you can get at the food in back without moving anything in front. And how about your frozen things? Oh yes, there's a place for them too, in this big, big food freezer. Even your ice cubes have a special place for storage, right here. And watch how they get there. You just take out a tray, turn it over, and push. You get a shower of ice cubes,
fuck that,
all
actually,
frosty
yeah.
dry and ready
I,
to use.
I have never seen that.
That looks like a lot of work to make ice.
I also want to say that that's what the ice maker does.
See all the wonderful but ideas.
It's automatic.
Refrigerators
nowadays.
Back then were so much more functional, and they did not really look like this. Like this shelf that comes off iconic, and the shelf.
It's because of modernity. It's because of modernity. Everybody loves a good, sleek, simple, concise thing. It's like been form over function for a long time, right?
I think
what it came down to. Like, does that 1956, you know, refrigerator have a fucking iPad on the front though? I'm just saying, you know, it's pros and cons. There's pros and cons.
Belt pulling out is just great. Why have refrigerators gone downhill since then? Refrigerators.
Three more.
What the fuck, Pedro? Seven times this week, huh? Bro, I got ping on you. Oh my. Oh yeah.
Boy, what the fuck? Harder next time.
Oh yeah, what the? You give me a fever. I don't even know how to read, fucker. Oh, what the?
It seems racist.
I have jokes on you, buddy. I have two.
You know what? Wait.
What the fuck, Pedro?
That last one got me, but I did not like the rest of the video. I'm gonna be honest. Everything else was kind of like.
Oh, what? Did you laugh though?
At the anime voice,
you
I did.
Okay.
Hell yeah! Maybe not out loud, but internally, I was dying.
Well, then I guess you're just gonna be honest with yourself. We'll go ahead and give
your
second point. No, it was a terrible video up into the anime part. As soon as he said "nummy," I was like, fuck. But
that's
then
what
I
got me too.
I immediately looked over to you and I'm like, please go off, bitch.
Yeah, I mean, the rest of it was like pretty racist.
I didn't get it. Don't explain the joke, I guess.
Nope.
I don't know what's going
There's
on.
No joke. There's
no joke.
Joke.
Okay.
Except for the anime voice. That was funny.
Did you feel pressured into being physical with Miss Luna?
No, I instigated it. After school, I went in and said, what could I do for some extra credit? And it was on.
Oh no.
How would you describe your mental state after the affair began?
I'd say it felt like what Disneyland is.
Oh my god, so embarrassing.
Mr. Daly, when your classmates became aware of your relationship.
That's cool.
What happened next?
I know, it makes me almost forget about joking about like pedophilia.
Yes,
wait, what?
Isn't that what this joke is? He's a student who had an affair with his teacher.
I think the thing on the right is taking up too much of my attention. I didn't hear that part at all. I just saw Pete Davidson in a courtroom and viscous stuff.
Yeah, honestly, like I think the video would be better if it was just the stuff on the right.
Yeah.
Do you know about the couple who was asked to stay in a room for 50 days, and if they could do it, they would get $5 million?
Hey, we have the same paneling.
Dollars.
Wait, to stay in a room for how long?
So it's a really basic room, and basically the couple has to stay in this room for 50 days, and if one of them leave, the prize goes down from $5 million to $1 million. So the couple has no...
Is there food? Because that's so easy.
Yeah, $1 million is still a lot of money.
Yeah, but also, like you pay me less.
All they have is each other. There's no entertainment. There's really nothing to do at all. So the couple's names is Mike and Kate. And when they get into the room for the first time, they look around and they think the room is beautiful. The room is completely covered in white. And all they have is a bed, a bench, and like a bathroom. And that is it. And Mike and Kate have been through a lot. And they've been through a lot of struggles. So they finally thought this is their opportunity to finally be comfortable and live a good life. So in the room, the bathroom has a rule where only one person can go in the bathroom at a time.
That's kind of weird because they're a couple.
Yeah. So on the wall, there's also this red button. And if they press the red button, that allows the doors to open, and that means they want to leave. There's also a touchscreen on the wall where it allows them to buy treats. And at the very top of the wall, there's this countdown clock that's counting down the days, like the 50 days. And every day they're given this new nutritious food, but it's in a white bottle with no taste, but it has all the nutrients they need. It literally just says food on it.
Okay, this room sounds like it sucks.
So every day the lights change from like morning to show afternoon to show night. So after the first night, they wake up to take a shower and they change their clothes and they're just given a new pair of pajamas. And as time goes by, they realize it's hard to keep each other entertained. So Kate starts to do yoga and Mike just stands around looking at the clock, counting down the 50 days. And then Kate keeps trying to tell Mike, like, stop looking at the clock. It's going to make it really hard for you. And Mike's like, no, I have to look. Like, he can't do it. So at night, Mike has a hard time sleeping. All he does is stays up and starts thinking about things. So the next morning, Kate tries to help lift Mike's spirits. Yeah. So she's like trying to play games with him.
They like
with
really
like
need,
cake
they're
with
relying
them, so Mike
on this cake.
To get
hey, little Tim.
All right, two kids, one room, one boy, one girl. Perfectly reasonable bed here. I like that bed, actually. It's perfectly nice. And they got two little desks to do homework at. Never mind, the kids going to a full MMA match because they fucking hate it. Let's design it the way they want. We're going to start off by getting a bunch of metal, and we're going to put that together. We're going to weld it together. We're going to get exactly one leg bolt, and we're going to attach it in the middle so it won't pivot at all. It'll be perfectly safe. One support beam, and there we go. We got a perfect bed. They actually had a better mattress before. They actually downgraded the mattress to afford this reno. It sucks being poor, but if you're going to be poor, you might as well be poor with prison mattresses. You're going to be spending a lot of time there anyway. Once we do that, we got the nice little outlet into the mirrored wall, which is kind of cool. You can charge your phone up there, and then we're going to wall it off. Then we're going to break that wall. We're going to waste a bunch of material here to install a sliding glass window. That way you can really have the feeling of being safe while not actually having any of the safety, because you just open it and fall out anyway. Get some curtains so you feel like you're in a tiny little hotel, and you're perfectly fine. We're then going to get to work on yet another little platform made out of metal, cover the metal with wood so it's cheap and easy, and fill it with a bunch of toys and board games. Look at how lovely that is. That's perfectly nice. And then we're going to have a nice little step up all the way up there. It's going to be friggin' awesome when your sister gets up in the morning, opens a drawer and has the lights off, and you walk down and you fall into your toy box and break your ankle in half. Chalk wall going up. Look at the phantom child going all the way up to his bed. Oh, he loves it. Perfect. He already died falling out of the window. We just didn't see that part because you're not allowed to show kids dying on TV. Isn't that amazing? We're going to have a massive wardrobe to hold all of their clothes. It seems like the boy has all the clothes here and the girl has none. And then we're going to get to work in closing off yet another wall to then break down most of the wall. Look at how lovely this is. See-through glass door and okay, goes right in here, so the brother can creep over to the sister for some reason and have a nice window into her room. And we're going to install her a normal bed with a prison mattress, and then we're going to pad that off with a different color. It looks actually really nice and cozy. I would prefer the bottom bunk, to be honest with you. The girl got the lucky bed here. Drawers underneath the bed that you're going to fill with all the socks that have ever been used in the entire world. And we're going to put some disco rolling skate wheels on there. Perfect. Corner cabinet to hold all of her law books, and we're perfectly good. This is a nice room for the boys and the girls. Why not? And then we're going to randomly make the desk super deep so anything that gets over there's... The girl has no privacy. The boy can look in at any time. It's creepy. It's creepy. Ghost kids. Yeah.
Okay. I hate TikTok.
How did we make it through 2 minutes of that one, though? Like, there's something there. There's something there.
I mean, that shit was entertaining, though.
It was.
I laughed like 3 times throughout that one.
I tried
good.
Really hard not to. I was trying so hard. It could have gotten me. It took me a moment to realize, like, he was being sarcastic, though.
Yeah.
Like, for a second, I was like, are you sure, though?
TikTok's fucking wild. Listen, you know, we were trying to do you laugh, you lose, but I'm walking away with the point that TikTok's not designed always to make you laugh. It's I think there's a good cringe factor.
Yeah.
That it relies on.
I agree. So. Or like just I sometimes it's educational. Like, they try to sound educational. Like they have that educational aesthetic or that education
for sure. And they've gotten so good too at like distilling a lot of information down into bite size. I really just hate the fucking 2 minute videos. I think they're so stupid. You could just make a part one, part two or something.
45 seconds. I like 45 seconds.
That's just ridiculous. I don't know if that's just part of like my little zoomer brain or ADHD, because I can't, you lose me, dude. Like, you really lose me. I just can't focus. This guy, dude, I think there was just a lot going on. Like, and kept me
in the speed at which he was talking to.
It was like a kid walked out of a, like, a door. The wall was getting smashed. Mm. You know what I mean?
We didn't see
fighting.
Him die, but he did die.
But he did die, and then the windows kept appearing, and the walls
Phantom
went away.
Kids.
I don't know what was going on there. It was a fucking chaos, and I liked it. It was great. I don't know, but I don't know. I probably won't continue to use this TikTok account. I think it could be fun for future content. It's so random. It's very chaotic. I don't know what's going on.
One more. One more.
One more?
One more.
All right, one more. One more, and then we're going to end it. One more. Un mas. God damn it, TikTok. What do you got for us? There's no rhyme or reason for this.
We all remember this legendary video.
Bro,
No, do you understand what your mama about to do to you, bro?
Where is my phone?
Use mine. Bro, so scared he about to snitch on himself.
Sad. Oh, he's like,
mommy. Oh. When I was shooting the BB gun, I accidentally shot the one that it accidentally hit the glass door.
Don't speak.
And all the glass fell. Yes. The screen door.
That's exactly what
I expect. All right. Oh, hold on. Oh, let me see. Who did it?
Wrong.
What he did?
He bounced off the wall. Oh. Don't keep it that way.
His video's too fucking long.
I think we got someone give this kid an award. He came out with the truth. He's cleaning it up.
He's a good kid.
He called. He didn't even wait till they got home. He called ahead.
He's a good kid.
He's packing his bags. He's ready to go. I think that's hilarious.
Oh, he thinks he's getting kicked out.
He's on the road now.
Oh, he's fucking useless.
Starting a new life.
His little siblings are so fucked up. Like, you're out of here, kid. I don't know what to tell you. Mom's going to disown your ass as soon as you get home, bro. I don't know.
Bro, where you at?
Bye.
Where you going?
Yo, you could add a 3 to mine. That got me.
Bro, come back, bro.
That's a thoughtful ass little kid, though.
It is.
Man, this boy hitting the fleet got me doing the work, nah.
He done fucked this.
He done, then look what he did. He gonna sweep it.
Okay, maybe that kid did fucked up. I mean, he's a tiny child.
What a cutie though, dude. All right, it's raining outside. We're gonna enjoy some rain, maybe have some more hot coffee.
Hell yeah.
Episode 30.
Pretty good. 3-0.
Pretty good. More to come. So stay tuned and subscribe.